Hey guys, welcome to Tech with Nick. I'm your host Niklas, and today I'm going to show you how I increase my productivity and deliver features 3 times faster than I used to, simply by replacing VS Code. First of all, this is not another video telling you to use Vim. Don't get me wrong, I love Vim and I use it, but this is something else, something described as the perfect pair programming tool. So let me jump on my computer and share my screen and show you exactly what I'm talking about. Let's get started. So let me introduce Cursor. Cursor is a fork of VS Code made by some brilliant people. It's described as if VS Code and ChatGPT had a baby. So it's basically VS Code with enhanced AI features. In Cursor, you get direct access to ChatGPT, allowing you to chat and use it to write code directly in your editor. And I did first learn about this a couple of months ago, and I've been using it since that. And I must say, it's incredible. It allows me to quickly come up with concepts and solve my problems directly in my editor. So you're probably wondering, how much does this cost? It's free and it has a generous 50 GPT 4 users and 200 GPT 3.5 users. If you use it a lot, you can upgrade and only pay $20 a month. And this is the monthly price. They have a discount if you use it yearly. But one great thing about this is you don't have to pay the monthly subscription. You can, if you want, use your own OpenAI key. The benefits of using their service is the response times. It's a lot quicker, and I do think they use Asia ChatGPT business under the hood, so their response times is a lot faster than the official OpenAI API. Another great thing about Cursor is the local mode. With this turned on, they won't store your code and they won't use it to train their models. If you do pay for the OpenAI API key, that OpenAI isn't using API requests to train their models. But enough talk, let me show you exactly how to use this. Alright guys, to show you just how this works, I'm going to create a Next.js project so we have something to play around with. Alright, so just created the project, and as when you're using a VS Code, you have the ability to use code dot inside the folder. Cursor allows you to do exactly the same just by using Cursor. When you install it, you have the ability to use code dot instead of Cursor if you want to replace. But at the time I installed this, I wasn't sure I was going to replace my VS Code. All right, so we opened up in Cursor. As you can see, it looks exactly like VS Code. You can use the same extensions you're used to in VS Code. So basically it is VS Code, just with the AI enhanced capability. To use the AI, all you gotta do is just remove some of all this, ask the AI to create something. So it's a command K on Mac, and I think it's control K on Windows, I'm not sure. Here you have the ability to toggle if you wanna use GPT-4 or 3.5. So I'm going to ask it to create a navigation bar, just something simple, just to show you how this works. All right, and we're off to the races, and it's starting to generate. It did create a whole new home function. If you use the context when you initiate the prompt, you can use the whole file. Basically, very simple, make a back background. It does look decent, honestly. And it did understand the commands very quickly. Did it create this? And it's a simple command. That's basically it. That's how easy it is to create a navigation bar using the AI. So there's another option. You can hit command L and you can open a chat. This allows you to chat directly. This could be basically anything you would ask ChatGPT. Give it a good prompt, it will give you a good result. All right guys, let's see just how well GPT-4 performs when doing this. So I made a brand new file, called it nav.gsx. Wanted to create a navigation bar. This should be responsive and on mobile devices. Hide the menu and only show it when you click the button. Background color should be black, text color blue, and with a nice hover effect. On bigger devices, the menu should be shown all the time, and it should style it using Tailwind CSS. It should create the whole React component, and each link should include an icon besides the text. Let's see if GPT-4 can handle this. All right, so it's done. Let's see how it did. So it does import the React, it imports icons from hero icons. That's pretty cool. Not sure if these exist, and I definitely haven't installed the package, but that's a minor detail. Does create a state for the open bar, has a home, about us, and contacts page. Does use a icon besides text. This is pretty cool. So I'm not going in depth in the code, but as you can see, pretty good. And it does it all inside your IDE. I'll just go and accept this, and all I need to do now is install hero icons, and I should have a menu working. Pretty exciting. This saves a ton of time. I'm just asking directly in your chat, how do you do this? and get the answer directly from ChatGPT. And the cool thing is the whole code base context thing. So you can use your whole code base. If it's a lot of files, it's a lot of tokens. So be aware of that. You can use that and get a pretty good response. Now you might be wondering, why not just use Copilot? And Copilot is pretty good. This uses the newest models. So you can use the ChatGPT, always updated, and you can't really do that on Copilot. I want to show you how much this costs, just so you know how cheap this actually is to work with. So let's have a look at how much does this cost. It's actually pretty cheap. I'm just going to refresh this. This is the OpenAI API platform. And I'm going to select today. So we can have a look. I recorded this in chunks. First time I used the GPT-3. This is the first request. Made the menu. It was less than 700 tokens. And then 3000 tokens for the second chat. So in total, today I spent 3 cents. And the most expensive part is obviously the GPT-4. Pricing for the different models is roughly 10x. So GPT-4 costs roughly 10 times as much as using GPT-3.5. So depending on how much you use GPT-4, this could be expensive. And if you're doing a lot of work, I would highly recommend to support Cursor and buy one of the packages, simply because it supports the work and gives you faster access to GPT-4. You have a roughly idea of how much this will cost. There you have it, guys. Thank you for watching this video, and please hit the like and subscribe if this is something you would like to see more. I highly appreciate it. It allows me to keep making videos for you guys. So please hit the like and subscribe and ring the little bell notification. I'll see you in the next video.